What is up, guys? This is Max Square, and in this video, we're taking a look at an After Effects pack with a ton of awesome glitch transitions and title effects. It's actually super easy to use, but they look really cool, and you can use them in both After Effects and Premiere Pro. Now, if you're new here, I make videos all about how to increase your productivity on your Mac, iPad, and iPhone, so if that's something you're into, consider subscribing down below. So the best part about this pack is it's actually super cheap at only 15 bucks. So you can click the link in the description and you can check that out. Full disclosure, that is an affiliated link, which means I do get a small cut, but it just goes toward helping out the channel, and I'd really appreciate it if you use that link. Now, unfortunately, there is not too much instruction on how to use this pack, but hopefully I can help you guys with this video so you kind of know what you're doing. It took me a minute to figure everything out. As you can see, the instructional folder is called How to Costumize and Not Customize, but that's all good. They do show you how to do the basics of setting up the template and swapping out the text and whatnot. But you see we have two different folders, one for the transitions and one for the typeface. Now they do have support back to CS5 for After Effects, so you should be good. And then of course they go all the way up to the latest CC. But you'll notice for the typeface, there are actually two different versions. There's a clean version, and then there's one with VHS noise. I didn't actually see too much of a difference between these two projects. I'll show you what they look like later on in the video, but that's just something to keep in mind when you're opening these up. So the project is pretty lightweight. It just has two main folders, one with the glitch transitions. That's really all you need to know. And then there is a project elements folder, which just includes some of the sound effects and some of the other previews that it's rendering out. Now there are 31 different transitions, and the best way to find which one you want to use is probably just to reference the product page. He actually has all of the different types listed out in order. So you've got firewall, dirty, keystone, extreme, and it just keeps going. So it actually shows you a preview of all the different effects. That's probably going to be your best bet. And if you want to maybe even save this link to that folder, then you don't have to keep pulling it up. But you can see these are all really usable. So I'm just going to go pick one random one. I'm going to go with burst. And we're gonna open up the burst preview. So this is just gonna give you a preview of what everything looks like. Now you'll see we actually have a couple of different durations for this effect. Some of them are really long, like the first one, but some of them are really quick, like this one. It's just a couple of frames and then it snaps to the next clip. But all of them do have some variation of the sound effect. So no matter which one you pull in, it's gonna have that ready to go. But all we really need to do to use this transition is just to create a composition and drag in some clips. So I'm just gonna call this test comp because I'm super creative like that. So I've got my two clips pulled in here. It's just a slider shot of the office. And I really wanna cut between those two clips using that effect. So all I have to do is just grab the duration that I want. So I'm gonna grab super, bring that in on the top, and then I'm gonna place that between the two clips right where it cuts in. Now, one thing you have to do in order for this to work is check that continually rasterized icon. It's just between those other three icons next to the track mat. And that is basically just the magic button to make it all work. And this is what it looks like when it's all good to go. So it's pretty subtle, but it adds an original look and it's something different just to cut between two different clips. So let's try this with a different effect. I'm gonna grab the glitch soft and I'm gonna put the max duration on that one. Place it between the two, check that, and let's see what that looks like. Now, if you felt like it, you could totally stack these effects. So right now I'm using glitch soft 28, but I'm gonna grab cinema from 20 and I'm gonna drag in the max as well. Place it over, check that. And it's probably gonna override that effect and we might have both of them, see what it looks like. But if we wanted, we could bring down the opacity to something like 50. And kind of mix in the two there. So it's a little crazy, but if that's the style you're going for, you can totally go with that. Now I'm gonna use a super short one just to show you how quick it is to add these in. Check that one more time and let's see what this looks like. So it's really easy to add, but it looks super complex. It actually looks like you spent a lot of time making these transitions, but really you just drag these in from the pack and that's all you had to do. Now currently we're just working inside of After Effects, but if you wanted to add this to a sequence inside of Premiere Pro, you can totally do that using the dynamic link between the two apps. So I'm gonna show you how to do that. So I've gone ahead and recreated that sequence with those two same clips. And what you wanna do to add the effect is just select the two clips that you wanna blend, right click and select replace with After Effects composition. Now you can save this wherever you want. I'm gonna actually save it inside of that glitch transitions folder and just hit save. And then it'll just jump over into After Effects with that composition. So you do wanna make sure that you have the template project opened up inside of After Effects already so that it comes into the right project. But now you're inside of After Effects with the clips from Premiere and you can add in that same clip. So I'm just gonna add in the Handycam effect. And once it's finished rendering, we can actually watch that back inside of After Effects and that transition is good to go. Then we can just save that project, jump back into Premiere, and you'll probably wanna render out those two clips. But once that's done, you can actually watch back that composition from After Effects with the glitch effect. Now the only downside about using these effects inside of Premiere is it doesn't actually bring in the sound effects for the transition, which is a little disappointing, but you can always go into the project elements and just grab a sound effect and then trim it up to that clip. And you're good to go. Next, let's go ahead and take a look at some of the title options that we have. So like I said earlier, we do have two different versions, one with that VH noise effect and then one that's just clean. I'm just gonna use the clean version for now. Now we do have 35 different title options here in the clean version. Of course, there's gonna be more if you open up the VHS option. So right off the bat, we've got a preview of all of the different titles, and I'd say this is probably the best way to find whichever title and effect you're looking for. These are pretty colorful. They've got some really cool effects, and I'm just gonna pick one random one here, maybe this 9 or 8, I don't know which one this is. But once you find the one you want, you can just double click on that composition and then double click into write text and just add whatever text you want. So I'm just gonna say, hey, it's Max Square. And then you can align that to the composition. You jump back to the main comp and it's all updated and you're good to go. These also have some sound effects, which are really cool. So you can mess around with these as much as you want inside of AE. One thing I would recommend is that if you do want the title to extend a little bit longer, because they pretty much animate on and animate off immediately, if you want it to kind of stick around for a little bit longer, what I would do is kind of make another composition. So just call this my title. And then bring in the composition that you're working with. So I was using 8. And you can just find wherever it is that it starts to animate off. So that will be around about here. What you wanna do is just hit Alt right bracket. That'll trim the clip there. You can duplicate it, extend that clip out, and hit Alt left bracket. That'll trim it again. And what you wanna do is right click, go to time, and select freeze frame. And then you can just extend this layer as long as you want it to hold on for. So it'll animate on like so, and then it'll just hold that frame. And let's say we want it to start animating off around 4 seconds. You can go there, select our duplicate layer, hit Alt right bracket. Go to the first layer, duplicate that, bring that to the top. And then what you wanna do is just drag that top layer so it lines up where we trimmed it with our playhead. And we're gonna extend that to the end and hit Alt left bracket, and we've got the animation off. So if we watch it start to finish, we animate on, we have it hold for a couple seconds, and then it'll just animate off. Now bringing these into Premiere is actually even easier than using the glitch transitions. All you have to do is actually just save this project. So I'll just save this to that project folder. Then just open up Premiere and drag that After Effects file onto your project timeline. Then a window will pop up and you can go find that composition with the title. So again, I was using 8, so you just open up that folder, go to 8, select 8 and hit okay. Then that title will just be imported and you can drag that into your sequence like you would any other clip. But what's really cool is that it is actually still dynamically linked. So if I were to jump back into After Effects and change this to say, hey, it's me, or something random, as soon as you save that, you can jump back into Premiere and you'll see that that text is updated and good to go. Now, just like we did in After Effects, if you did want to extend that title a little bit, I would do the same thing. Just go right before it starts to animate off, so right around there. You can just splice that clip and then just right click and select insert frame hold segment. And then again, you can just drag that frame hold as long as you want it to hold. It'll hold that layer and then animate off. So guys, that is just a brief review and demonstration of this After Effects pack. As you can see, it's really easy to just swap out your text and use these transitions in both After Effects and Premiere. I think it's a really cool effect and you get all the benefits of using these animations, but you didn't have to do any of the work. Also, because the project files are so small, they're only about 20 or 30 megs, you can really use these for each project, just duplicate the file, and then you get all the titles and transitions again. You're not having to delete work from past projects or anything like that. Anyway, guys, that is it for this video. I hope you all enjoyed. If so, be sure to hit that like button and subscribe for more content just like this. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in the next one.